Welcome back to CeADAR Lighthouse Project AI Digital Twin Series. In our journey, we will explore the concept of AIDT and the various associated use cases. Today, we are taking a step further. As we have seen, AIDT can revolutionize urban planning and management. But to do that, they need data, lots of data, and not just any data. They need diverse, comprehensive datasets that reflect the complexity and the variability of human behavior and decision-making. That is where synthetic data comes in. But how do we generate the synthetic data, and how can it be used to improve our AIDT? In this video, we will explore how we can simulate human behaviors to generate synthetic data, and how this data can enhance the capabilities of our AIDT. So let's dive in and uncover the exciting possibilities of synthetic data generation. AIDT is a powerful tool, but one of the great challenges we now encounter is generating comprehensive datasets. We need that accurately reflect the complexity of human activities, like traffic data, energy consumption data, or even various monetary data, and so on. Real-world data can provide some of the information, but it has its limitations. Collecting the real-world data can be time-consuming and costly, and there are lots of limitations of the real-world data, like privacy concerns and lack the diversity, and so on. Moreover, it may not cover all possible scenarios or represent all segments of the population. This is where synthetic data comes in. So, how do we simulate human behaviors to generate synthetic data? One answer is the simulation of generative agents with large language model. The process of simulating human behaviors to generate synthetic data begins with the creation of the generative agents. They are AI characters, but each agent has its own unique identity and characteristics. They live in a virtual environment and have their own runtimes, interactions, and decisions, all powered by the large language models. These agents can simulate complex human behaviors, providing a rich source of synthetic data. As the generative agents go about their virtual lives, they generate a VLC of synthetic data, and this data recorded as detailed logs of the agent's experience and actions can be used to train and improve the AIDT. This processing of simulating human behavior to generate synthetic data provides a valuable resources for training and improve the AI system. It allows for the creation of diverse and comprehensive datasets that accurately reflect the complexity of the human behaviors. But how does this work in practice? Let's take a look at the real-world example in the next section. Well, we will explore the Sims-inspired sandbox environment used to generate synthetic data. To bring this concept to life, let's look at the real-world example. In a research paper titled Generative Agents, Interactive Simulacra of Human Behavior, the authors create a sandbox environment reminiscent of the popular games, The Sims. This environment's small villa serves as the playground for the generative agents. In this environment, generative agents interact with each other and their surroundings in a similar term. Each agent has a unique identity and goes about the day performing activity and making decisions, and then interacting with each agent. And each agent in the small town is represented by a simple spirit avatar and has a unique identity, including the occupation and the relationships with other agents. These identities serve as seed memories for the agents, informing the behaviors and the interactions. The agents interact with the world through the actions and with each other through natural language. At each time step of the sandbox and engine, the agents output a natural language statement describing the current action, which is the translate into the concrete movement in the sandbox world. The agent's actions and experience are recorded in a memory stream, a long-term memory model that stored the agent's experience in natural language. The memory stream serves as a detailed log of the agent's behavior and is a rich source of the synthetic data. In addition to influencing the agent's individual action, the memory stream also plays a role in an agent's interactions with other agents. For instance, if an agent memory have a positive interaction with another agent, it may decide to approach that agent for a conversation in the future. Conversely, if an agent remembers have a negative interaction with another agent, it may decide to avoid the agent in the future. This ability to learn from the past experience and adjust the future behavior accordingly is a key feature of the generative agent architecture. The sandbox environment provides a fascinating example of how we can simulate human behavior to generate synthetic data. The synthetic data generated in the environment can be used to train and improve the AIDT, providing a valuable resource for the development of the smart city. So, how can we apply this synthetic data to AIDT? The answer is the power of the machine learning. AIDT is essentially machine learning models that train to mimic the behavior of the real-world counterpart. To train these models, we need a large amount of data of the real world. The synthetic data generated by the simulating behavior providing the valuable resources for the training process. It can cover a wide range of scenarios and populations, making it more diverse and comprehensive than the real-world data. As we continue to explore the possibilities of AI digital twin and the synthetic data, we look forward to a future of smart city and more efficient, sustainable to the needs of the residents. Thank you for joining us on the journey into the world of AIDT and the synthetic data generation. If you are interested in our content, please subscribe our channel and the newsletter, and we will give you more interesting information about AIDT. Thank you. See you in next video.